to the administration of Bafarawa. The road network in the state was a big concern for Sokoto state populace. There was traffic congestion in the state capital. The major roads were flooded during rainy season, and some parts of the roads were not accessible due to innumerable potholes. In the rural areas, less than 30% of the roads in the local government areas were motorable throughout the year. In a nutshell, it was difficult for the people of the state to move around easily and to transport their products to the market both within and outside the state. Today, Sokoto State is a force to reckon with in terms of educational attainment, both Western and Islamic education. Health services are second to none both in rural and urban settlements of the state. Erratic water and electric supplies are no longer the case. The quality of good roads and efficient road network in Sokoto State is second to none. The media, the judiciary, virtually all sectors of the economy have witnessed a tremendous development courtesy Bafarawa administration. Within the past 6 years of Bafarawa administration, total renovation of the government house took place. Construction of a modern governor's office complex is near completion. This beautiful edifice is built to cost 300 million when completed. There was a complete renovation of all the houses in legislators' quarters. The assembly complex was generously renovated too. Other structures reconstructed include the old governor's residence after it was razed by fire.
Beside this office you are seeing, he completed the other governor's residence. Immediately he came into this government, that was the first thing he did when he was elected governor. He finished the resident before embarking on this project.
Government house, clinic and mosque were not left aside in the renovation exercise. In an effort to provide befitting accommodation to guests of the state government, including the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Presidential Lodge was reconstructed and additional 6 villas were built at Government Lodge, Sokoto. Education is a springboard of every sustainable development. The most valuable asset one can bequeath to a generation is education. Intellectual skills acquired via education are the basic instrument required for developing and sustaining communities, nations, and the world at large. It is with this understanding that this administration did wonderfully well in this area of human endeavor. During the period under review, the state government did not only implement national policies on education, but also provided necessary facilities and created a favorable environment for effective learning.
He renovated the school very well. He provided all the facilities. And I believe there's a serious change in the school.
Dilapidated ones were rehabilitated. These classrooms were thoroughly furnished with good seats and tables.
This school has almost the best structure as far as I know, and I think I just have to praise His Excellency Alhaji Taheru Alhaji Bafarawa Gargaon Sokoto for his wonderful, I have to underline that word, wonderful performance in governance.
Computers with internet facilities were provided for many schools. Modern books were also made available for schools and state libraries. There are 34 boarding schools, including 3 primary schools with students currently numbering 33,832. Suffice it to say that primary, secondary and university students enjoy free education in Sokoto State. This includes feeding, accommodation, books and fees for those in boarding schools.
Yeah, exactly. The student has peace of mind now. They know their hostel is okay. The classes is okay. The students have enough mattresses, blankets given by the state government. Almost everything is free here. The feeding, the books, everything is free.
The administration of Alhaji Dr. Atairu Bafarawa went as far as purchasing WAEC, NECO, and UME and other examination forms for the state indigenous.
The registration of our students to write NECO, or to write SSCE, or to write NAFTEF, government is paying free of charge.
Scholarship scheme was also provided for the state indigents pursuing courses all over the country and beyond. The state government sponsored 50 students to study medicine in Bulgaria. They're billed to be back before the end of 2007.
We have students that are pursuing specialized programs in Bulgaria. If you could recall, 2-3 years back, government sponsored about 50 students that are pursuing medical MBBS program in Bulgaria. I'm pleased to say that of those 50 students, we've not had any casualties so far.
503 classroom blocks each were constructed in the 23 local government areas. Apart from that, 6.4 billion naira was launched for primary education resuscitation project, under which additional 1,000 classroom blocks of 3 classrooms each are being built across the length and breadth of the state. Under the Ministry of Science and Technology, Bafarawa administration handled a lot of projects that really improved the standard of science and technical education in the state. Those projects include rehabilitation of the physics, chemistry, agriculture, biology and computer laboratories in virtually all the science and technical schools.
The school was established in 1975.